What 30 seconds feels like it lasts the longest? Hire a guy, subscribe now, or I will poo on your desk. The moments after sending a risky text and you see, so-and-so is typing, but it keeps starting and stopping. Reminds me of a tweet that went something like, you ever send a text that's so risky, you clean your entire house better than being left on read. You can no longer send messages to this contact. At least you have a definitive reaction closure in that instance. Left on read is kinda worse. I asked this girl out one time. We were friends, but not really close, so I felt like it was a good potential date opportunity and put myself out there. It wasn't the first message between us or anything. She just left it on read. I would 1000% rather get a straight rude response in return than no response whatsoever. It basically led to 2 days of self-consciousness until I concluded that she doesn't respect me, nor I her any more that shit. When I sent my crush a confession and she took 3 days to tell me she likes me back, thinking I would think of her badly for liking me. Weird girl. It sounds like she actually just needed time to process how she felt about you but didn't want to tell you that unskippable 30 second ad. It's interesting how now I can't stand a 5 second ad on YouTube, and when I was a kid it was normal to watch 10 minutes of ads every 20 minutes of TV programming. Never thought of it like that. I suppose it's because TV shows are designed to cater to that ad break. I.e. stories are normally told in 2 parts, usually with a cliffhanger in the middle to keep you around for part 2. A bit like an interval in a play, YouTube videos aren't like that. The ads can happen in the middle of a sentence so it's more shocking to the viewer. You actually recognize it as an advert rather than an ad break. YouTube ads have gotten obnoxious. How the hell do you cram 2 ad breaks in a 5-minute video? All videos are starting off with 2 ads before the video even plays. It's infuriating, and sometimes I don't even know if I want to watch the video. I just saw it pop up and wanted to see what it was, but it's only 5 minutes long and YouTube expects me to wait through 2 unskippable 30 second ads. Then another 2 halfway through. I'm ridiculous. Having happy birthday sung to you. What do I do with my face? What do I do with my hands? What do I do with my eyes? It was the damnedest thing. We were just singing happy birthday when he reached for a fork and tried to stab out his own eye. I remember a time me and some friends went out to dinner and the staff came out with the cake and candles singing, and I thought cool. Someone's birthday. Then as they surrounded me and kept singing, I looked so confused about what was going on. Cause it wasn't even my birthday. Just one of the girls thought it would be a funny prank. Lmao, I'd be sweating real hard if I were you. Trying to put my change back in my wallet in line at the convenience store with people in line behind me, or when your card won't read in the debit machine, but you know you have the money in your account so you have to run it 2 or 3 more times. I just shove my money in my pockets and put it in my wallet later. I just cut to the chase and throw my change on the floor before apologizing profusely and rolling around in an attempt to pick it up. It's inevitably going to happen anyway. Waiting for someone to get out of the bathroom, and then you just have to hold your breath and hurry. Don't stress the bathroom guy, it doesn't really help. Been there, done that. Ugh, I was once waiting in a line outside a public bathroom, and this middle-aged lady starts jiggling the door handle. I'm like, yeah, it's occupied, and she goes, sometimes they need a reminder that people are waiting. There's no moral to this story. It just made me mad. Once, I'm stuck in a restaurant bathroom, small restaurant, and they only had 1 bathroom for everyone. I am a survivor of anal cancer, and I still often have a lot of pain with this, though I doesn't really take any longer. So, I'm in there, and this person starts rattling the doorknob. I shout, I'm in here, I'll be out in a minute. Few seconds later, rattle rattle, I answered the same, maybe a little louder. Next thing I know, someone is unlocking the door and starting to push it open. I was glad I could reach it with my foot to hold it shut as I was screaming. I said, somebody is I'm in here and I'll be out in a minute. Manager didn't apologize or anything if I'm going there again. Getting past the scene while watching a movie with your parents. Suddenly I feel like staring at the floor. Going to pee or drink water or stare at the wall or check my phone. Proceed to freeze on seat while the scene plays. Happy cake day. I left the hope that someone will wish me. It brought a smile on my face. Thanks fellow Redditor. Edit thanks to all the fellow Redditors who wished me. All of you are breathtaking. You made my day. Edit to this has been overwhelming. Thanks for all the wishes. I'm going to sleep now. Will reach back to all of you who I couldn't reach right now first thing in the morning. Thanks all the guys and gals. Good day and good night to everyone who is reading this. Daddy, is that woman going to die dart? Judging by the size of the horse's cock, I'd say so. That gooey stuff they put in your mouth when you have braces. Yo, I did this and my gag reflex was so bad I started crying and retching at the same time, then I let out the largest burp I've ever had and it echoed throughout the entire office. Mayo. Same. My gag reflex has always been intense. I think it took them like 5 tries to get an okay mold. Weirdly enough, I don't have that bad of a gag reflex normally. Like, it's nothing to write home about, but I'm not one of those gags while brushing their teeth types either. I'm pretty solidly average. Whatever that goop was, though, just set me off. I couldn't do it, full stop. I almost immediately started choking until I was full on crying. It took several tries to get me all the way through it. I'm gagging a little bit just remembering it, and it's been at least 15 years since I last had it done. The terrible taste, smell, gritty texture of that putty will haunt my nightmares until my dying day. When someone says we need to talk, the best response to that is yeah. We do. Congrats. Now we're both scared dead it. Holy crap. This blew up. Thank you. I accidentally scared my boyfriend doing something similar. We were texting one time and I missed him and wanted to hear his voice, so just texted asking if he could call instead of responding to his text. He called immediately, worried something was wrong. Poor guy. I'm much more careful now. My best friend would text things like, can we get dinner tonight? There's something I've wanted to talk to you about. I won't tell you what it is because I don't want you to be anxious, but it has to do with you. It might be bad. It depends how you take it. But don't worry about it. We'll talk about it tonight. And then she'd only respond with, I'll tell you later to any questions. And then completely ignore me until we met up. She did this at least once a year and I started getting anxiety attacks every time she'd message me politely because I knew it was going to be something she was holding a grudge about for months. She'd act like she's being charitable for at least telling me and not ghosting me. It took me an embarrassingly long time for me to realize that what she was doing was shitty. My toothbrush vibrates every 30 seconds letting me know it's time to switch sides. Sometimes it feels like I brushed for 4 minutes and it vibrates again. Edit. Thanks for the awards even though I'm not sure what they mean. Edit 2. I own a Sonica, not a quip. But I may be joining the group soon. Okay, question. I just got an electric toothbrush. How on earth do you spit without having toothpaste drool dribble down your chin? I can't take the brush out, because then it sprays the drool all over the bathroom. If I don't spit, it still runs out. I just got an electric toothbrush, and I have to wash my beard every time I use it. Edit. Thank you all for the kind, and not so kind, replies. I am not using way too much toothpaste. The small bristles don't hold as much as a regular toothbrush, and I've never been one to use toothpaste like the commercials. I will try using less though, and that may solve the problem. As I said in my original comment, simply removing the toothbrush from my mouth would create the bigger problem of the spinning brush flinging pasty water all over the bathroom. A few years ago coming home from camp I had to pee so bad like it hurt for probably 15 minutes that how bad it was, so the bus stopped and I had to get off the bus and pee on the side of the road. What really sucked was that the road was next to a hill and I had to go partly up the hill because there was barbed wire about halfway up. I had to pee so bad because I drank around 2 liters of water in one shot before the bus left. I went to a Christian camp, and all of the counselors urged us to stay hydrated. That I did. Which led to me having to pee during the chapel services. The first night it hurt to walk, hurt to pee. Somehow it made it so much more difficult to pee but still hurt the same. All cause I committed to staying in the service. Next night I didn't try that again and I had to leave early. That was the clearest my pee has been for my entire life. That's all right, guys. And don't forget, please subscribe or I will poo on your desk.